So a lot of people want to know, how much are they going to get? How many conversions, how many customers, how many sales can they get back for $10 a day, $100 a day, and $1,000 a day? And that's exactly why I'm making this video. Now, if you're brand new to this channel, my name is Devin Thomas, and what we do is we create Google Ads tutorials for complete beginners. So if that's something that you'd be interested in, hit that like, subscribe, and also hit that bell button so that you can get notified when I drop new tutorials, just like this one. Now, I know a lot of people are hesitant to get started with Google Ads because really they don't know what they're going to get back for their budget, and they're scared that Google might overcharge their cards, or they're scared that they might not get any conversions at all after spending all of this money, or get no sales at all, or get no customers at all. So I wanted to make this video and give you some realistic estimates. I'm going to split this video into four parts. The first part is going to be billing, basically how, when, and why Google Ads charges you. Second part is going to be your budget breakdown, where I tell you exactly what to expect for $100 a day, $10 a day, and $1,000 per day spent on Google Ads, more or less what type of conversions and performance you can expect back. Third thing we're going to talk about is, how do you forecast your budget? How do you actually predict, if I spend X amount, I'm going to get X amount back? So I'm going to show you a real cool tool for that. And the last part we're going to talk about is just things I wish I knew before I started off with Google Ads, especially around budgeting and how to actually spend my budget so I can get the best results possible. I wish I had this video 6 years ago, but anyway, let's get started. So let's talk about how and when Google Ads charges your card. So the first piece of very good news I'm going to give you is that Google Ads is only charging whatever budget you set for yourself. So if you want to set a daily budget of $1 per day, no problem. Google Ads will work with your $1 per day, and they will only run ads for $1 per day. Or if you set it at $5 per day, they will only use that $5 per day as your daily budget. So funny story, when I started off with Google Ads 6 years ago, I could only afford $1 a day, and I kind of made a $1 per day budget work. It got me leads, it got me customers, not enough customers and not enough leads, but obviously as I started getting more and more business in, I could then scale my budget. So you really can start from anywhere. You don't have to have a ton of money to start off with Google Ads. So let's say we are spending this $1 per day. Does that mean every single day Google Ads is going to take $1, $1, $1 off your card? Definitely not. So this is how it works. Google Ads is going to give you a threshold. Like you can see on screen right now, my threshold for my ads account is about $350, which means I get to spend up to $350 before they deduct any money from my credit card or from my card whatsoever. Now, the cool thing about this is, let's say for example, if you had a budget of, I don't know, $10 a day, and you had a limit of $350, you could actually just spend your normal budget, and if you don't hit threshold, they will not bill you at all during the course of the month. They'll only bill you on the first of the next month. So even though my threshold is like $350, if I don't hit it, it's fine. Google Ads won't take any money off my card until it gets to the first. That's when they take the money off. All right. And also, some of you might be wondering, like, what happens if Google Ads overcharges you? Like, they spend more money than they're supposed to, and that is more than what you set your daily budget at. Well, your daily budget gets calculated over 31 days. But let's say, for example, we had $10 over 31 days, but Google overspent. Now, I'm going to show you one of my invoices on screen, and you'll see that if you look under the adjustments, there's something there that says over delivery. So in other words, Google has overshowed my ads. If that ever happens, they will deduct that from the amount that they owe you. So you really have no risk when you're taking on Google Ads. And now, because of Google, I can go and buy myself a nice coffee with my $1.96 that I saved from adjustments. Thank you, Google. Moving on. Okay, so now we figured out how billing works, but what exactly is Google Ads charging us for? Well, When you're running a search ad or AdWords, you're basically selecting different keywords and you're telling Google to show your ad in the search results whenever somebody types in that keyword or types in something related to that specific keyword. Now, showing your ads on the search results is completely free. You don't get charged for that at all, but you do get charged when somebody clicks on your specific ad. This is why it's called PPC or paid per click marketing, because you're only getting charged when somebody clicks on your ads. If they just look at your ad and they don't click, you don't pay anything for it. Now, this is extremely cool because you need to write effective ads, but if you don't get your ad right, it's not a problem because you're not paying just to have your ad shown. Now, when it comes to display, YouTube and video ads, it works slightly differently, where you'll get charged per impression. And your impression is obviously every time somebody sees your ad. Like if somebody sees your display ad, you'll get charged. If somebody sees your YouTube video, yes, you will definitely get charged for that ad as well. All right, so now you know how it works. Let's talk about what you can get if you spend $10 per day on your Google Ads. Now, the first thing I'm gonna tell you is that if you're in the USA or if you're thinking about advertising in the USA, do not run search ads with just $10 a day. The clicks are way too expensive and you probably won't even get your ad shown with such a small budget. Just to give you an example, different areas will have different cost per click. So if you look in the USA, your cost per click for a keyword like web designer would be between $6 and $18, and that's just for a single click. However, if you look in South Africa, it'll be much cheaper, less than $2. So yes, in South Africa, I can get away with $10 per day running search ads, but not so in the United States, purely because there's more competition in the USA, and also the clients in the USA tend to spend a lot more on websites. So if you can't run search ads, what type of ads should you run for $10 per day? So I would advise that you start off with your Gmail or your discovery ads, or you could also start off with video ads or YouTube ads, as that's a great place to start if you only have $10 a day, and your $10 per day will stretch much further. Also, if you don't know what those ads are and what they look like, I've already got a whole video here where I show every single type of Google ad and I explain it with examples. So make sure you check it out that way. So for $10 per day, you could expect about a conversion every second or every third day, and that's about 10 conversions per month. That's more or less what you're looking at for $10 per day. Let's increase our budget to $100 per day and see exactly what we can get back for that. So the first thing I'm going to tell you is $100 per day is more than enough to run a fantastic search campaign, and it's enough for a beginner search campaign. So no problems there at all. Now, what I suggest you do is take the $100 and split it up into different types of campaigns. So $70 going towards your search campaign, $20 going towards a YouTube ad campaign, and the remaining $10, I would spend that on a retargeting campaign. So you're using the search campaign to get customers off search, you're using the $20 to get customers from YouTube, and you're using the $10 to basically retarget anyone who's visited your website and who didn't buy the very first time. Now, I will say this, if you're in the financial services sector, it's just not going to be enough. $100 is not going to be enough at all, because just for a click on an insurance ad in the USA, it could easily be between $50 to $150 just for a single click. So there you might struggle. However, most industries, this would be more than fine to start off with. Another thing that I'm going to say is you're looking at about 2 or 3 conversions or leads from your ads every single day. So it's kind of a good place to start if you're a business owner and you want to start building some momentum online. So $100 would get you about 2 or 3 conversions per day. We're talking about 90 conversions per month. All right, that's $100. Let's go on to $1,000. Now, what would I do with $1,000 per day on Google Ads? I would take that money and take $700 and put it straight towards a search campaign. The search campaign would bring me clients that are urgent because they're searching Google right now and they probably need the product or service right now. And also search campaigns are some of the highest converting types of Google ads out there. So obviously, no brainer, you want to put $700 towards a search campaign. The balance of the cash I would split between YouTube ads, maybe a Performance Max campaign, display ads, and a remarketing campaign as well. So I would go about it and split the budget something like $700 for search, $150 for the video ads or YouTube ads, and I take $50 towards Performance Max, $50 towards display, and the balance towards a remarketing campaign. Another cool thing about spending $1,000 per day on Google Ads is Google Ads allows you to be eligible for what's called a remarketing list. Now with the remarketing list, you can basically show ads to your entire email base. So let's say you have 2,000 people or 15,000 people on the email newsletter that haven't bought from you. You can basically upload all of those email addresses to Google Ads, and Google Ads will show remarketing ads to them until they buy. Now stay tuned to the channel because I'm going to be having a full tutorial step-by-step guide on that, so it's a good reason to subscribe. And if you haven't subscribed, make sure you subscribe right now. So some of you might be watching this video and screaming at me on your TV or your cell phone screen and telling me there is no way that we're gonna get such low cost conversions in my industry because my industry is competitive, my industry is different, my click costs are high, my cost per acquisition are high. There is no way we're gonna get so many conversions by spending that amount of money, Devin. Well, my friends, I've got some more good news for you. I am going to show you a tool where you can work out your own unique cost per acquisition for your own unique situation. So let's get into the screen share. All right, so I'm logged into my Google Ads account, and what I'm gonna do is click on Tools and Settings, and I'm gonna go over to something called Keyword Planner. Now, your dashboard might look different than mine. It's probably because you're not in expert mode. I'll leave a link below to switch to expert mode. Alternatively, you can just search Google Ads Keyword Planner or Google Keyword Planner, and in the search results, it'll come up with that as well. I'll leave that in the description below as well. So I'm gonna click Keyword Planner, and then I'm gonna say, discover new keywords, and then what I want to do is I'm going to select my location. So in this case, I'm going to type in USA and I'm going to say save. Next thing I'm going to do is type in a keyword. So I'm just going to put in electrician and I'm just going to say get results. Now, when I do that, you'll see I get all of these results down here. Now, I can see my average monthly searches. I can see what the competition for each keyword is. And I can also see more or less what the clicks are going to cost. So this is like a range between $4 and $27 is what I can expect to pay per click on the keyword electrician. And I'm just going to select the first 10 keywords. Now, if you really want to know how to select keywords and how to find really good ones, I'm going to leave a link for my keyword research tutorial. Really awesome tutorial, and it really guides you with how to find the best keywords that will get you the most conversions. So I'm going to say add to plan. Now, once I do that, you'll see these little green bubbles pop up on the right hand side, and it'll all say that these keywords are in plan. And I think I've added about 10 keywords. The next thing you want to do is head over to forecast. When you're in forecast, you can literally see what you can get for a 10K, a 1K budget. Let's just say I want to change my average budget through to about $100. Let's just do that. There we go. And it's going to tell me how many clicks I can expect, what sort of impressions I can expect, what sort of cost I can expect to pay, my click-through rate, and my average cost per click. So what you want to do now is you want to go and add your conversion metrics. So if you know that your website converts about 2 or 3% of people, I'm just going to put 3%, you can add your conversion rate over here, say save, and then what it's going to do is it's going to come up with your average cost per acquisition. So this is more or less how much you're going to get back for, how many conversions you can expect to get back for average budget of $100 per day. Obviously, I think they take this over 1 month. Now, a slight word of caution, Google Ads is always going to try and tell you that you're going to get low numbers.
That's because they've got this on maximized clicks or manual CPC. And I always advise my students to start off their campaigns with manual CPC. And hey, guess what? I got another video on how to switch to manual CPC. I'll put that down below in the description as well. So that's basically how you can see what you're gonna get before you even spend any money.
So you're all ready to go with Google Ads. You know exactly what your budget is and you know exactly what you're gonna get for your budget. But before I let you go, I just want to share some hard-earned advice, and if you just indulge me for a few minutes, I will tell you exactly what not to do with your budget on Google Ads. So the first thing you want to keep in mind is that even if you're spending $100 per day, you don't want to start off your campaign by spending the full $100. What you want to do is start off by spending about 40% of your intended budget. So for the first week, spend about only $40 per day, even if you can afford the full $100 per day. Why do I say this? It's because Google is notorious for showing your ads on unrelated searches, and it takes about a week or 3 weeks to optimize your campaign. So what I would suggest you do is start off with about 40% of your intended daily budget, and as you optimize and as you clear out the bad searches and as you add negative keywords and as you find out what's working and what's not working, you want to then increase it every single week by about 20% till you're at the full $100 per day. I hope that makes sense, because if you spend all of your money, that $100 per day, instantaneously, you're going to be under a lot of financial pressure straight away. And I want you to enjoy the optimization campaign. So try and spend 40% of your budget first and work your way up to spending the full 100% of your budget. The second thing I want to tell you is that Google Ads is always going to recommend that you increase your budget. You will get notifications, Google Ads will tell you you're not spending enough, even if you're spending $100,000 per day. And I've seen this myself. You will still get the recommendation that you're not spending enough and you should increase your budget. I would ignore those and I would focus on your key performance indicators. I would focus on your cost per conversion and how much your ads are actually costing you and if you're making money and if it makes sense to scale. So even if you get increase your budget, don't really pay attention to it unless you do obviously have the funds and it doesn't hurt you too much to increase your budget. The last thing I want to tell you is that it's quite normal to have fluctuations. So for example, one day you might get 10 leads, the next day you might get 2 leads, the next day you might get no leads, and then the next day you might get no leads, and then the next day you might get 5 leads again. It's perfectly normal, and these are just normal market fluctuations. Remember, there are going to be certain times during the month where people are more interested in your products and services, and there's going to be certain times of the month where people just don't have the money to put towards those products and services. So for example, in South Africa, we know that from the 20th of the month to about the 4th of the next month, that's where we get all of the action with our campaigns, and the rest of the weeks is quiet. Why? Because people haven't gotten paid yet, therefore they're not searching for products or services as aggressively. So it's quite normal to have fluctuations. Don't think that every day has to be the exact same as every previous day. All right, so you know everything there is to know. The next thing I want to do is just invite you to check out my small budget, big results free workshop. Now, this is completely free. You don't have to pay anything to join it. But the cool thing is I will take you step by step and show you exactly what you need to do to make a small budget work in Google Ads. Now, I'm going to include the link in the description below, and I'll just be going over the specifics and every single detail that you need to really, really get the best bang for your buck in Google Ads. So if that's something that you'd be interested in, and if you want to hear me talk for another hour about Google Ads, make sure you click the link in the description below, and I'll see you over there. So thank you very much for watching this video till the end. I really appreciate it. I know it was a long video, but I've got so much that I wanted to share with you. If you're looking for something to watch next, check out my keyword research video. I'm going to put it over here, and be sure to like, subscribe, share this video with a friend if you found it useful. And I'm so excited for you to begin your journey with Google Ads. I will see you next time. Peace.